So my old friend Beatte Chelette, the CEO of the Women's Code, she has a video that I will not replay here because I think maybe the last video I did, having a discussion with Beatte may have earned me a community strike. So no, I'm not going to use her audio. You can see the video yourself down below with the link. If you want to piss and moan, you want to vent, you want to call her an ex, or do it in my comments. Don't go up there and do it on hers, all right? Please do me that favor. We're just trying to have a discussion about these things. And I don't want to spread hate. So do the hate here, not up on her channel. I appreciate that. Thank you very much. So Beatte did a video called Maternity Leave for Men. Why we should be encouraging father's parental leave. Excuse me. Shiner Bach. Every drop is made in Shiner, Texas, y'all. So I wrote a comment here, basically. She was saying, blah, 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 blah. As if the 1993 law about family and medical leave doesn't exist. Because it does. Let me just give you the brief highlights. This is from the Department of Labor. And I know this is a little bit dry, guys, but I'll get around to it here eventually. Family and Medical Leave Act, passed by Bill Clinton, 1993, provides certain employees with up to 12 weeks of unpaid job-protected leave per year with their health insurance paid. Every employee in the United States, this is a federal law, Beatte. This is not a state-by-state thing. This is not a blah, 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 or whatever you said. This is a federal law that has been in effect for 26 years. You have a baby, you can take 12 weeks off. Just that, I mean, how much easier can it get? Here, maybe, is what Beatte is talking about. The leave, if you're married, has to be split. So the husband can take 6 weeks, she could take 6 weeks, she could take, you know, 9 weeks, he could take 3. But if they're married, you only get a total of 12. Now, we could have this discussion. Maybe he should get 12 weeks as well and not split it. Oh, okay. We could talk about that. But here is the comment from Beatte Chelette of the Women's Code that got the hamster spinning on the wheel just a little bit. She writes, no, they are not guaranteed 12 weeks of leave. It is factually incorrect. It is up to the employer. The most progressive states offer at most 6 weeks, often with no pay or at 40% pay. And then she shamed the hamster for not making as much money as her. Ooh, I feel so bad, Beatte. So the fact is, Beatte, in the United States, employers who have 50 or more employees, there's a couple of other caveats, right? You can't just work part-time. You have to work a certain number of hours, you know, all of this stuff. But if you meet all of these simple criteria, you are guaranteed by federal law 12 weeks off, medical benefits paid, and they have to give you your job back. Now, I don't know what's factually incorrect. I've got the Department of Labor explaining it. Link below. Now, Beatte, look, sweetie, we can talk about these things. Rationally, we could say, okay, maybe we need to make a change over here. Maybe there's something we could do better over there. We could do that. But you have to start out with facts, reality, not some fantasy that, you know, you've had in your head since 1993, when evidently you weren't paying attention to a Family Leave Act. Beatte, having a child is a choice. Government can't tell you to have a kid. Your employer can't tell you to have a kid. It is your choice alone. A female's choice, actually. Men have nothing to fucking say about it, but let's not go down that road. It is your choice. If you don't feel financially ready or you want free whatever to have your baby, that's your problem. It's not my problem. The choices I make in life, I fucking pay for. I go to college and I get student loans, I pay it back. If I buy a car, you're not on the hook for it. I am. It's the same goddamn thing. And if you can't afford it, you can't handle a couple of weeks without pay, that is not my problem. Life is a series of choices, Beata. You choose a career, you choose a baby, you choose something in the middle. It's up to you. But to expect someone else to fucking pay for it is bullshit. And that's really what we're getting at here, guys. She wants all free shit because women are oppressed and they should be able to have babies if they want to. I should be able to have a Mercedes Benz if I want to. No one's going to pay for my choices in life, Beata. No one is going to pay or should be expected to pay for a woman's personal choice. All the links below. James Maxwell, thank you for listening.